bill, which was reintroduced in this year in February 2012, that is anti-homosexuality bill, which was thrown in the previous parliament, but this year it was introduced, and apparently it's, the debate is almost on in the Ugandan parliament, and there were speculations that it should be passed before the end of this year, and actually from the members also from the community generally, they were asking the Speaker of Parliament to give them the Christmas gift, and the Christmas gift they were demanding was the anti-homosexuality bill.
That's what I mean.
Yes.
Are you scared?
If you mean of that, yes, absolutely, I'm very scared, because the bill is very dangerous. It's not just about me, homosexual, but it's about my family, it's about people around me, it's about my friends, it's about doctors, it's about the nurses, it's about the teachers, because the bill itself in context is not good, because it's like if they don't report me, if it's passed and they don't report me in any authority, if that's my family, they're all going to be arrested. Punishment, 7 years. If you have to pay a penalty, 5 million. If you're my friend and you don't report me to the police, and the police gets to know that you know that I'm a friend and I'm gay, and you don't report me.
Homosexuality is an African and un-Christian.
What kind of a question is that? I was born when I was gay. I grew up in the village. I only came to Kampala when I was 21, and I had already slept with more than 15, 16 people in the bush. They are those who take care of the cattle. I had never seen a white person. How do you tell me that homosexuality is important?
There is some people who say that homosexuality is un-African and un-Christian. What do you say about that?
What I would say is that there's a lot of misinformation. We need to be more informed, and that is part of my work. I've been trying to dispel this kind of argument, which is wrong. It is Africa. This thing is for humanity. Even in the Bible, before people went to Africa, they were talking about sexuality. So the point is to understand, is it a sin or not? It has been there.
Okay, what should be the religious leader's role in this to stop the anti-gay bill in Uganda? What should be the role of the religious leaders?
Well, we are divided. I'm a religious leader, but I think the role should be to support the oppressed. Because me on my side, I'm a Christian. And Jesus is telling us to help the oppressed people and not to continue oppressing them. So that's why I'm on the side of trying to help the people oppressed. For it is not their fault to be created in that way. They are created in the image of God, but they are different from other people because we are not all alike.
It is no question that the struggle to promote the inherent dignity and equality of all people, regardless of their sexual orientation or gender identity, is one of the most fiercely contested struggles. It's one of the few issues that has African traditionalists joining forces with Western religious groups to attack lesbian, gay, bisexual, transgender, and intersex Africans. Religious fundamentalists of every persuasion find common cause in proclaiming that homosexuality subverts the natural